March 2011, AIDS.gov attended the Conference on Human Retroviruses and Opportunistic Infections in Boston, Massachusetts.
Hi, this is Miguel Gomez with AIDS.gov. I'm here with a colleague at CROI. Sir, you presented twice on MSM-related issues. Could you introduce yourself and what did you talk about?
Sure. Hi, Miguel. It's a pleasure to speak with you. My name is Greg Millett. I am a senior behavioral scientist at the Centers for Disease Control. And while here at CROI, I've had the honor to talk about MSM and the domestic HIV epidemic, particularly what is placing MSM at greater risk for HIV infection. We see disparities, incredible racial and ethnic disparities among MSM in the United States, and those disparities are not due to sexual risk. That Black and Latino MSM are actually engaging in comparable, if not less, risk behavior compared with white MSM, but are still more likely to become infected. And some of that has to do with the background prevalence of HIV in our communities that make it easier for us to come into contact with someone who's positive compared to people in other communities. But you also don't see those disparate rates among MSM of color. You see those disparate rates among MSM generally. CDC had data showing that MSM are 40 times more likely to become infected with HIV in the United States compared with heterosexuals. And one of my talks was focusing on why we're seeing these disparate rates among MSM compared to heterosexuals in the U.S. And there's quite a bit of data out there showing that it's not really due to risk behavior either, that most MSM who become infected with HIV become infected in the context of a relationship from their main sexual partner. There are also data out there showing that role versatility among MSM actually transmit HIV much more efficiently than among heterosexuals. So for instance, MSM are more likely to engage in sex as the receptive partner as well as the insertive partner, and that increases their likelihood of becoming infected with HIV. Whereas among heterosexuals in the United States, it's usually the male who's the insertive partner, and women are less efficient to transmit HIV to their male partners. So that makes the epidemic somewhat lower among heterosexuals.
Important information. How would you like the provider community to use the information that you just shared with us?
There are several things that providers can do. Well, one of my presentations that I didn't talk too much about was a presentation showing that even among MSM who disclose their sexuality to providers, that they're not being diagnosed with HIV. First and foremost, we need to be able to have providers test those men who they know are homosexually active for HIV infection. It's just a shame that we are still in this day and age, 30 years into the epidemic, that there are men who are cycling in and out of the healthcare system with unrecognized HIV infection, even though they have contact with providers. So we need to try and increase comfortability among providers to discuss sexuality in a frank way and to provide testing. We also need to deal with issues in terms of stigmatization, not only for Black and Latino MSM, but stigmatization for MSM in general. We know that stigmatization is part of the reason why some MSM are not getting tested as regularly as CDC recommends each year. That stigmatization, of course, is also involved with why some MSM are not seeking access to care once they're diagnosed with HIV in a timely manner. So the whole stigma issue is certainly something that we need to address as well. And certainly something that we're very interested in looking at as we move forward with implementing the President's National HIV AIDS Strategy. For the last several years, it seems like HIV and AIDS has dropped off the radar. There are many important issues that are facing our community. We also need room to really take a critical look at HIV and AIDS again. It's very clear when you take a look at the surveillance data that's out there that the only population in the United States where HIV rates are increasing are among men who have sex with men. We can't go into another generation where becoming HIV positive is a rite of passage for young men who are coming to adolescence. And we need to really engage our national leaders in the GLBT community to really try and prevent that from happening.
Well, sir, thank you very much for your time today. If you want to hear Greg's presentation at the CROI conference, please go to the CROI website. I want to thank you. This is Miguel Gomez with AIDS.gov.